So today we'll look at website monetization. Monetization simply means being able to monetize your website or your blog site. I'm sure we are familiar with the blogs like Better Naija, Lindy Cage, and the forums like Naraland and the rest. These people have been able to monetize their traffic. They've been able to monetize their website, their blog site, and their forum. Okay, let's just look at Naraland. Okay, this is Bella Naija. Here, I'm sure you can see adverts here and there. This is an advert. This is an advert. I think when we scroll down, there are a couple of other ads. Okay, you can find more adverts here and there. Okay, these are adverts on the platform. If you go to this is Naraland. You can see adverts here and there. Okay, let's check out a blog. This is alternative advert blog, for example. You can see adverts. So this is known as website monetization. Now there are two ways to monetize websites. One is the regular banner ads. Like these banners here, it's known as banner ads. Another way to monetize a website is by posts. Most of these posts we see, like this is Bella Naija, for example. Most of these posts within her blog are paid for. The owners of the news pay for this item, but the cost varies from website to website. So you need to understand, and also the traffic to the website determines the cost of the post. Like for example, I think Bella charges about 26,200 naira or thereabout for any post on her website, while Lindy Cage charges about 50,000 per post. Naraland, I don't know how they do theirs. I'm sure they charges, though most of the posts here are done by other individual. But if you want Naraland to maybe post on your behalf or boost, I think they have a way of doing that, but I'm not very familiar with theirs, but I'm sure it's possible. This is Lindy Cage loading. Okay, you can see banners here and there. These are the horizontal banners or leaderboard. And then you can see banners here and there. And some of the posts here, some of the posts on her website, aside from these celebrity gist and all that, aside from the celebrity gist, other posts are paid for. Aside from the celebrity gist that bring her traffic and all that, other posts by companies are paid for. So those are the two ways of monetizing your website. One, by getting banners to your website. Two, by posting, getting people to pay. So you post their items. It could be their events, their... just hype their product on your website, do an article on them and post it on your web, on your either your blog site, your forum, or your webs or your news site. Those are the two method of monetizing. Now, when it comes to banner monetizing, you have also two formats. One is what we call direct ad. Direct ad is when the owner of the business or the banner pay you. Somebody says, if you can see my screen, maybe check your internet connection or reload. Okay, so when it comes to banner monetization, as I said before, we have two formats. We have the direct advert. Direct advert is the owner come to you and place the advert directly with you. And there's also what we call third-party adverts or third-party ad banners. Third-party ad banners is when people go to the ad networks and place the adverts, and the advert will then display on your own website or your blog site. We have ad networks like Google. We have the Google AdSense, it's an ad network. We have alternative adverts. We have Yahoo has their own ad network. There are several ad networks out there you can join. But the most common or most popular within here in Nigeria is alternative adverts and Google. Okay, somebody's asking that I should explain the third-party adverts. Okay, third-party advert is when you go to the ad networks like alternative advert and sign up as a publisher, or you go to Google and sign up as a publisher. These people, this network will give you a code you need to place on your website, and this code will in turn show adverts from their various advertisers on your website. And you'll be paid each time somebody either click on your website or click on the adverts or view that you can see these are ads. Let me look at, okay, this is an alternative advert blog, for example. These adverts are paid for. When you reload the page, you find out that, okay, if you reload the page, you see the ads will change. Okay, the page is reloading. The ad will change and display advert from another advertiser. You can see it has changed. This is an advertiser altogether. So you keep rotating the ad among, okay, this is an advertiser and all that. So the ad network help you have so many ads on your website, because as if your website has a fewer traffic or it's a new website, it might not be easy to get a business owner to pay you to advertise on your website. The first thing to do is sign up with ad network and get ads on your website. When the business people see it, and they see it, when they see the different kind of ad on your website, they will see your website to be relevant and want to advertise with you. Most doesn't even know the difference between direct ads and third-party ads. Hope that is clear. And just as I mentioned before, one of the most common third-party ad in Nigeria is alternativeadvert.com. Just go to alternativeadvert.com or search for that alternative advert online. Just go to Google or another search engine and search for alternative adverts. From alternative ad, when you get alternative advert, you see it's loaded. Okay, this is publisher. You select publisher and create an account as a publisher. Just fill up your information and then you get other details along with video that will guide you on how to get the code. Another one is also Google. You can go to google.com. When you go to google.com, on the left side, bottom left, you see advertising. Click on advertising. And then you have two options. It says advertise on Google, make money from your website. So this is the part you need to choose. Click get started to give you room to fill up your information and all that. And you can sign up with them. Though most people complain that Google are very strict and they ban accounts here and there. That is true, because people have been abusing the ad network, and every ad network it gets becoming more strict these days. Though alternative adverts still have some tolerance, for at least for the time being, but it's not enough reason to abuse it, because they will also start banning you as time goes on. So please, these are the two platforms to sign up with. There are lots of others you can search yourself by going to Google and other search engine to search for ad networks. Can sign up with them. When you sign up with them, you'll be able to copy ad code and then place it on your website. Now, any question before we go on? If you have any question, drop it on the chat. Or somebody's asking if I can brush it, repeat all I have said. Okay, I'll just run through it once again and then we'll move on. First of all, I said before, today we are talking about four items. Yeah, two, Well, that's okay. Three items. We say we're talking about website and blog monetization. We're talking about classified ad and then forum. So earlier, okay, before now I said blog monetization or website monetization has to do with you getting adverts on your website. You can make money with your or website or blog sites by placing adverts on your website. Okay, when I say, okay, so, okay, let me finish. I'll come back to your question. Someone is asking, what do I mean when I say people are abused? Okay, I'll come back to that. So website monetization, as I said before, it has to do with, okay, I gave an example of Bella Nigeria, Lindy Cage, Naira Land. Okay, like here, this is an advert. This is known as website monetization. This is an advert now on Bella Nigeria. Go to Naira Land, you also find adverts. You go to Lindy Cage, you find adverts. So it's known as website monetization. Can get people to pay you to place advert on your website. But I said before, it is easier to get advert to your website through using third party. By third party, I mean using Google ad networks. Ad networks like Google and then Alternative Advert. Those are the two popular ad networks here in Nigeria. Can go to these two websites and sign up as a publisher. And then they walk you through on how to generate ad code and place on your website. The ad code will in turn display advert, as you can see. This is advert from Alternative Adverts. You go to Bella, you see others. You go to Linda, you see more. So this ad network will enable you copy ad code and place on your website, which will in turn display advert of various advertisers on your website. And each time somebody click on it, you get paid. Now, there's another way of monetizing your website is writing an article about a company. As I mentioned before, that some of the articles you see, you read on Bella Nigeria, Alternative Advert Blog, Lindy Cage, Naira Land, and the rest of them are paid for by the owners of the article. It is known as sponsored post. So you can get people to pay you to write about their business or the products and services. But to do that, you need to first try to have enough traffic, make your website as popular as possible by maybe advertising it using platforms like Alternative Adverts, Google, Facebook, and rest of them. Get popular first, and then people can pay you to place adverts on your website. Now, as I mentioned before, that the cost of placing adverts on your website varies from website to website. A better Niger, for example, to place an article, it's called a prevent article. That is the article talking about your upcoming event, for example, or talking about your product. It's about, I think, about 26,200 or thereabouts, while better Lindy Cage is 50,000. The number of traffic to your website determines how much you should charge. Don't charge 50,000 because Bella charged 50, Linda charged 50. Don't also charge 26,000 because Bella charged 26,000. You can start small, even if you just 5,000 naira, 2,000 naira, but get people to know you. Because you're not losing. Even if somebody had paid you just 2,000 at the place to write that score about his or her product, you're not losing. Whether the person pay you or not, you would have seen gone out there to look for article to boost your website. But the more article on your website, the better. Now, for someone asking what I mean by people abusing ad network, I'll give an example. When you sign up with any of the ad network, Alternative Adverts or Google, you generate ad code and place on your website. They will warn you, don't click on your advert. I'll give an example. This is an advert coming from advertisers. This advert is paid for on per click. Each time somebody click on this advert, the website owner, which is Alternative Advert Blog, get paid, and the advertiser will be charged. So the same happened with this advert you see on Bella, on Linda, and several other websites. Each time someone click on adverts, the owner of the website get paid. So the ad network usually warn that you don't click on your advert. Don't click on advert on your website. Because if they notice you are doing that, or you are asking others to click on your on advert on your website, they will ban you. Because clicking on your website or getting others to click on your website, on the advert on your website, does not give any value to the advertiser. The ad network here has two main role. One is to satisfy the advertiser, to ensure the advertiser gets results. The second one is to make money for the publisher. But if that network allow the a publisher to abuse the advert of the advertiser, which means the publisher will make more money, but the advertiser will not make gain or will not even get value for what the money has paid. So at the end of the day, the advertiser will not come back. So it is their job to ensure that there is a balance, that no one is cheating the other. That's why you see Google and alternative advert and the rest banning publishers and then refusing to pay you whatever amount you have made because you have violated the policy. Somebody is asking, what are the requirements to get ads from Google or alternative advert? The requirement is just to sign up with them, as I mentioned before. Okay, I'll place a link now. Go to, I'm going to place the Google. Okay, this is, I'll take it from the beginning again. When you go to google.com, on the left side, click on advertising. And when you open, click on getting started under make money from your website. I'm going to place the link now on the chat. You can go there. That's for Google. Now, when you go to just sign up, follow the processes and all that is simple. Now, when you go to alternative advert, you do the same. But alternative advert is simpler. You go to publisher and select create account. Other publishers select create account. I'm also going to place the link on the chat so you can follow the link as well. I'll place the link of both alternative adverts and Google on the chat so you can follow the links. So, and just follow the, fill up your information, your name and other details, your email address, and then it's pretty simple. And verification takes just a couple of seconds. And all of them has video or some visual guide that will help you create the generate advert code, ad code, and place it on your website. I think with this, we are done with website monetization. Any more questions before we move on? Remember, if you want to ask a question, you can on your mic to and ask your question or drop it on the chat below the attendees list. So if there's no more question, we're going to move on to the next, which is we've explained website monetization, which is how to make money with your website. Someone says, is, are you going to teach us something on how to create a website? Wow. Well, I don't think that is part of the, it's not on the course outline, but maybe before the end of the training, we'll see what we can do about that. So we'll discuss with the team and see what we can do about creating a website. But at least even if we cannot teach you how to create a website, during the blog season, we're going to teach you how to create a blog site. So you see the same thing. But because creating a blog is faster and simpler than creating a regular website. Okay, so we're going to look at classified. Okay, these days I'm sure, okay, who knows any of the classified website out there? Can you give me an example of some? Somebody's asking, must one have a blog or a website before signing up as a publisher? Yes. You must have a blog, a website, a news site or something before you can sign up as a publisher. Because you need any of those platforms to sign up, because they will require the website or your blog site during the sign up process. It is those platforms you need to place the code. There's in the code you need to generate from each of those platforms and place it on your website. So do I have to have a specific number of traffic before? No, I think Google do have a limit on that. I think you need to have a specific number of traffic. If or you can sign up as a publisher. But it is not something difficult, just a couple of traffic. But for alternative advert, no. As long as your website does not contain adult content, which is like nude pictures, porn videos and all that, porn videos and all that, so you don't have a problem, you can always sign up. Be it a regular corporate website, blog site, news site, any kind of website that does not contain adult content. So you are free to sign up. So can someone list give me a name of some of the classified website, classified ad site we have out there. Let me know if we are on the same page. We have several classified ad sites out there. Who has an example of one or two? So I want Google Ad. No, Google Ads is not classified ads. Google Ad, an alternative advert, is known as Ad Network. Yes, Gigi. Somebody said Gigi. Gigi.ng is classified. Any other one? A lot of OLS, yes. OLS, okay, everything.com. Any other one? Okay, I think those are the three popular ones for now. Jumia. Jumia is more like a marketplace. So Jumia is more like a marketplace than classified. So Cheeky, I think, Cheeky can be classified, but I think they're building into marketplace right now. So there are several of them out there. So it is good you sign up with them and place your adverts. Though the advert might not be as effective as paid adverts, but it's also see good you place your advert with them, because somebody someday might be searching for something and stumble on your advert and be able to call you and patronize you. Remember, you're not paying anything aside from some of them that require you to pay a certain amount to maybe to be more visible. So you're not paying anything, so you're not actually losing it. Why not you give it a try? So please go to this list of this website I've listed that. Okay, let me try to paste. I think I made a list of some of them before now. We have from the other, we have OLS, Gigi, everything. So there are lots of others like Cheeky, somebody mentioned, and the rest of them. So please go there, sign up with them, place your adverts. They can be useful. Though it may not generate quick income and quick traffic, but it's important that you are visible in as many platforms as possible. More importantly, they are free, so why not give it a try? Someone is saying I should explain what classified ads is. Okay, classified ad is there is website out there that allow you advertise your products and services free. They allow you just list whatever thing you have to sell, be it services or product or even things to rent. So they allow you to just place anything out there free of charge. Though at some point they require you to pay a certain amount to be more visible, but all of them allow you to sign up free. So sign up, place your product, whatever you have to sell, services, products, fair use items and all that. Sign up with as many as possible and place your product or services there. Just as I said before, it might not be, the advert might not bring you fast income. Except you are saying something like a used phone. Yeah, used phone generates traffic. Maybe used phone, used cars, some household items actually are fast selling goods, so they generate a lot of traffic. So you can get quick call within hours. But if it's some other kind of services, if you don't get call immediately, don't give up. It will still come. Because some things I placed on forum 2-3 years ago, people still call till date. Yes, I say it might not be fast, but it is good and important. So sign up with them and then place your product. Another important platform is directories. There are lots of directories out there. We have vconnect.com, we have Nigerian Business Directory. There are a couple of other directories out there. Please go online and search for Nigerian Business Directories. There are lots of them out there. List your product. Well, the important thing is The more places your products or services are displayed, the better for your SEO. We did SEO some days back. So the more places the search engine can find your name, your business name, your website address, the more relevant you become, your business will seem to look. So go to four directories as well, list your businesses, list your products in as many directories as possible. So those are also important. Now the next, any question on directory and classified before we move on? Today is just more of talk and then we don't have, so we can leave you on time. Any more questions on directories and classified ads? Okay, if there's no more question, we'll move to the next, which is forum. We have several forums out there. The forums like classified is also a platform you can place your, advertise your products and services. We have the forum like Nairland, we have an entrepreneur forum, we have a, what's it called? Nigeria Best Forum. Which other forums do we have? Who have an idea? We have several forums out there. Please, can you drop it on the chat if you know if another forum out there aside from Nairaland, Netpreneur Forum, and the Nigerian Best Forum. But somebody said Nigeria Pal. Okay, Nigeria Pal is also another good forum. I think it's generating traffic these days. So go to Nigeria Pal. Okay, Gistmania. Okay, yes. Gistmania is another one. Gistmania. Okay, we also have Hottest Gist. Okay, yeah. Okay, we have Hottest Gist. Okay, let me drop some of them. Though netpreneur.com.ng forum is under maintenance, but it should be up later today or tomorrow. Batterbox. Yeah, somebody talked about this Batterbox. I'm actually hearing about it the second time, but I think you need to check it out. I must say Batterbox. Look at the, go under the chat. You find the list of forum people are listing there and drop yours too if you have any. Go, the chat is on that attendee list. So, okay, let me drop some. I'm going to okay, I want to drop some now under the chat. I think there are about four of them. We have a Nairaland, we have netpreneur.com.ng, hotage.com, Nigerian Best Forum. Those are the three I have offered right now. So you can go online, go on the chat, you find them. And go online, you also find lots of other forums. Try and join as much forum as possible. And make sure you try to post your product and services on the right category. These forums might delete your post or your advert if you place it on the wrong category. If you're into real estate, for example, look for real estate and drop your real estate listing, rent, and all that under real estate. If you're under, say under job, you want to post item on job, make sure you do that under jobs. Don't post things on the wrong category. They might delete it or block it totally. Someone says, can I get a link to download it? Yes, we're going to place it on a forum later. Today, once the forum is up, we have also sent it as an email and an SMS. So it's going to be on a go to Netpreneur Forum. I'm going to place the link again. Netpreneur.com.ng. We're going to place the two video of the both, including this. That is three video now. By the end of today, or latest by tomorrow, we have the two video on it. So go to netpreneur.com.ng, find a video. Find a video, three videos. Any more question? So if there's no question, okay, someone asked earlier, let me see. As a publisher, how do you get paid? Okay, each of those platforms will give you room to enter your bank detail. Each of them will give you room to enter your bank detail. So your amount will be paid into your bank. That is for alternative adverts. Why Google will have to send you a kind of a check? It might take weeks for the check to get to you, but once the check gets to you, You will need to open a domicile account or euro account or pounds account, depending on what current, depending on the currency selected on your account. If you have selected a current pounds as a currency on your publisher account to Google, you might have to create a pounds account. If it's euro or dollar, you might have to create a dollar account, because they're going to send you a check on that. But alternative advert, you can use your naira account. Just under a profile on top right when you log in, select inside the your bank detail. It could be corporate account, business account, or service account. Under the payment method, select bank and enter your details. So yeah, once at the end of the month, once your money get to $50, the money will be wired into your bank account. Any more question? Okay, if there is no question, okay, this is Hotel Gist. Hotel Gist is one of the fastest growing forum as well. Okay, let me go to okay, this is what I was trying to explain earlier. Like we have, like, this is Hotel Gist, for example. There is General Forum, there is Career, there is Hotel Gist, there is Autos, there is Brand and Personality Programming and different things. So make sure, if you're into auto Career, for example, you want to post job, make sure you post it under Career. If it's a general discussion, you can post it under General. Investment or e-commerce, post it under e-commerce or investment. Make sure you make your post inside the right category, so you don't get blocked by any of the platform. Your post get blocked most time or deleted totally because you place it in the wrong category. Make sure you place your advert or your news item or whatever into the right categories to avoid getting blocked. So this is Hotel Gist blog look like. You can see they also monetize it. They sign up with alternative advert to monetize their blog. You can see it's actually one of the fastest growing forum in Nigeria. So you can also try, when you create your own forum or if you have an existing one, try to, one key thing that will make people just as I said before, the Hotel Gist form is not available right now, so it should be up later today or by tomorrow. So what we have there is just information about the webinar, so just hold on, by later today or tomorrow, it should be up, and then you should be able to make your posts and make your posts, and then also have access to some of the videos we've done before now. And remember, you can also go to Hotel Gist, netpreneur.com.ng, the forum, to ask your questions. Even after this training, you can still go there to drop your question, and the expert, I will also be available to help you answer some of your questions, and other participants can also be there to help you. Let's make it as interactive as possible. Go there on a daily basis to look up for more, something new, and okay, you can also post your own news, post your own business, post your own views and all that. It is for all of us. Let's invite, make it as interactive as possible, and also invite others to join the discussion. So that is, if there are no more questions, I think that will be all for now. And so just as I mentioned, as I think you got a mail today stating that the next training will be on Saturday. That is to accommodate those who work, because they've been getting a complaint from those who work that they can't join the training during their working hour. So we want to try holding one on Saturday and see what the participation will be like, because we'll have so many people that actually register, but each time you have few people that is able to join the chat. The reason being that some of them are the working places and can't log in. Although we made the video available to all those that paid actually, so they still have they still follow up the video. But we also like to have some more people on the training so that the it will be more interactive and more interesting. So we have more people asking questions and following up with the discussion. So I think the normal question, I will call it a day. Thank you for being part of the training. We're going to get this the video across to you later today or by tomorrow as well, so you can have access to it. And then whatever, any of the topic you miss out or any part you didn't get where you can go back to it and then go back to the video and then refresh yourself on the areas you're having difficulty. But remember that even if you still cannot solve some issues yourself with the video, feel free to go to the forum, espreneur.com.ng, to drop your question later today. The forum should be up. Now we'll all join the discussion to help each other out on the questions and things bothering us. Thank you for joining the training today, and I hope you had you enjoyed the training today. There's a question here. I've opened a blog and I was asked to create a blog when I entered. I was also asked to enter the address and I didn't know what to do. Please, can you help? Okay, maybe what we do is somebody asking a question about blog. Maybe we could take a blogging on Saturday. I'm not sure yet because there is program schedule, but I'll discuss with the team and see if there's any way we can change. We can take blogging on Saturday, so we can walk us through on how to go about creating a blog, monetizing the blog, designing the blog, and all that. So thank you for being part of the training today, and see you on Saturday.